There's so many great supplements, but I think what overrides it, obviously, I think intensity is the number one. You're in the gym for an hour. These supplements really give you 150% return of your hour as opposed to other things, because it immediately goes to the body, because it's not really what you're taking, it's the timing of what you take and what your body absorbs. So we don't really grow in the gym, we all know. We get weaker, actually. Well, we create the demand for our body to grow outside with the rest of nutrition. So when we can do a hard workout, that sponge or muscle is now wrung out, it's ready to be absorbed, anything, we can pour on these supplements, which is like a concrete, more pure form that our muscle, the perfect food for it. And there's certain supplements you take at night, you know, that slow release, you know, protein with casein, you know, but right after the gym, you don't want to take that. And just like carbs and good carbs and bad carbs, what overrides a good carb or a bad carb is a good opportunity or bad opportunity to take it, because you don't want to take a good carb right before the gym. No, you want to take a bad carb, simple sugar. So in that time, a good carb is bad because of the timing. So my six are like, so protein, BCAAs, L-glutamine, creatine, HMB, like them both. You need your multivitamin, like you said, you need fish oil, pre-workout, you go. But number one is intensity and pussy, man. You gotta get that pussy out. Nothing drives
the
you.
The ultimate anabolic supplement.
Nothing drives you better. Nothing drives you better. You know, I don't carry gallons of water with me to the gym because we might have a shortage. I'm not tubwearing all my meals and stuff.
But there's certain things that we're obligated to do when we're getting ready for a competition, like every morning getting up and doing our fastest cardio and hitting our workouts and staying on schedule for each body part we're supposed to train,
and our food and our diet
being in accordance to what we're doing for that specific time. Everything has a plan.
Right. Do you see that as a sacrifice? You see it's like, oh man, I wish I could go out with the guys. I wish I could do that.
Of course, you know, I would rather eat a burger than eat tilapia and asparagus.
Yeah. I don't see that. Here's my biggest fucking issue with that, because a burger is a temporary satisfaction. Going out with the boys is a temporary relievement, you know. You won't remember any of those parties, but you'll frame that picture on your mantle. That means more to me in the balance of life, the achievement, your title, than any of the sacrifices of, oh, I can't eat a burger.
That's why we
fuck the burger, man. You know, you're trying to live legacy. Anyone can eat a burger, but not everyone can win.
I've never invoiced a magazine for a cover. I don't think I've ever gotten paid. What I've gotten paid is the networking. You know, you're building relationships with people. And so, yeah, you don't get the cheap.
You're talking publicity with the covers.
Yeah, that's all it really is, man. See, the public sees your cover next to GQ, who's a big movie star, right? And so they had this assimilation that, you know, you made it. I wish that was the case, man. I wish that was the case.
What comes after the cover? What comes after the 50th, the 100th, the 1,000th cover?
I can give you a million examples, but what happens after the contest? You know, how many plastic trophies is going to make you feel good? I mean, where's the money? Where's that start? Or is it about the money? Or is it about something else? At the end of the day, what's it about? So what's your driving force? It can't just be about you winning. There's got to be some higher point. Like, the gym can't be about the ends. The gym has to be the means to some ends.
I bought a house well over $1 million. I had, you know, 800,000 in the stock market. I was on a couple TV shows. I was doing commercials, everything else. Within 6 months, I was dead broke, 400,000 in debt. Both jobs were canceled and bills were steep coming in, man. There's a reality check real fast for you. And it wasn't like I did something to cause that. That was just an evolution of the market, housing market, and the recession that we all went into. Who are you there, you know? It's real easy in the EKG of life. It's kind of funny that the heartbeat is that, right? Because isn't that life itself? And who are you at the top? The character, who's that person? How are you defining yourself there? And is that different than down here? And if it is, something's seriously wrong, because you can never be defined by success. You must always define it. And when you get success, that person's hungry. You ask that person, hey, what are you all about? I'm going to be this. Talk about future. I'm going to be this. Then you ask somebody who has a success. The coin flips. All of a sudden, that success defines them. Oh, who are you? I did this. Well, there's a past tense there. And if it's past tense or it's idle, it's not moving, man. And you can't grow from that. You always have to reinvent the wheel, retry things, and you can never be a victim of the situation. It always has to be, it can never get too comfortable, man. Those comfort zones are really danger zones because you never try your true potential. But, you know, I had a big wake-up call, man. All my friends left me, you know. I thought they were friends, man. Gone, man. I started pointing my finger at everybody saying, that's crap, I can't believe that. Three were pointing back at me. I had to fix myself, man. I rescued three dogs, man. I'll support my parents, everything was going to go down. The dogs had to find a new place. I didn't know what was going to go down, man. I just knew that it wasn't an option. I started going, you know, Per Bernal, photographer. I went to his house during construction, man. I was doing construction. And I remember this girl came by. We shot a few covers. And she came by. She said, oh, great, cool. I was hoping we'd shoot together. I'm covering shit, man. Covered in shit. And she's like, we're not shooting together? I'm like, nah. She's like, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm trying to keep my house, man. You know, I couldn't go to auditions and then a call back and call back, not getting paid anything. And it wasn't fast enough. I had, these bills were coming in hard. I mean, $30K a month coming in, I had to throw out. You know, I had to grow up real fast, you know. Your greatest hour as a human is usually right after your worst hour of despair. And that was a rebound effect for me. And I look back at that as a blessing, man. People are like, hey, what's your biggest failure? What's your biggest failure? I go, I don't know if I have one, because each one of them molded something to me where I learned so much about myself. If I were to pull that out of my life, I don't know who I'd be right now. And I never let failure stand as failure. I just kept trying. You know, as they say, failure is temporary, giving up's permanent. I'd be damned if at the end of my days, man, I'm never gonna have any regrets.
There is no off season. I call that unemployment. And I can't tell you how many covers I've stolen where photographers have called me up and they'd be like, hey, Greg, whatchamacallit, couldn't make the flight or came in out of shape or whatever else. You know, what are you doing in an hour?
If we don't have a belief that we can become that person, that lack of a belief turns every journey into a debate. Pain versus pride. And pain starts to feel so much that all of a sudden we start second guessing who we want to be.
In our business, we're building a body. Then if you want to get smart and be successful, you got to have a business plan. You got to have a marketing scheme. You got to know how to deliver that product to the consumer. And that's what it's all about. And I think that's why I think TJ's been really successful. Dave has been successful, and a lot of other guys, is that they understand that their body is just the product. You know, it's nothing more than that. You build the product, and then you sell that product. When how you get the product, the motivation behind the product, how to maintain the product.
I mean, how many guys you see going to the gym, man, and it's like leg day, right? And it's they don't want to do that. That's their weakest day, right? They go into the gym and going to do legs, right? And all right, so they go in that off hour, no one's really there. But it so happens Sally's there, some girl that, you know, they want to hook up with. So all of a sudden, it doesn't become leg day, does it? Turns right into arm day or something, or chest day, so they can show off in front of Sally. That's someone that's doing something for a third party. You know, they don't pay your bills, yet you give them all this value. It makes no sense. If you really want Sally, you believe in what you want, you go after no matter what anyone says. And when then you reach those horizons, trust me, Sally and Sue and Nicole and everybody else is gonna come, and you get to pick your choice because you're a leader, man.
Because 99% of the world's average, but they don't look like that. What makes you get up in the morning and make this commitment? Because every other week or something, the world's gonna see us. And as you climb the ladder, everybody hates you. Everybody's waiting for your trip and fall. You know, with success, many will love you, the majority will hate you, because your success is like a spotlight shining down on their missed opportunity.
Like, I came back from overseas in the military, I was in a hotel lobby bar. I'm trying to work my game that night, trying to get the digits and get the shit situated, you know? And as I'm doing this, I get a tap on my shoulder, and you know, as an agent, and he keeps on talking to me, and he's like, hey man, you got a good look, you should come to my room, get some pictures. And I didn't know how to take that, man, you know? So, I mean, those were fighting words for me back in the day. So I went right up to his room right away and stripped out now. I told you, sexual favor.
That's how it all started.
No, but you know, I took his card down, man. You know, he's saying, hey, I can make you famous. I can get you a cover. I can do this. You know, you want to hear that, so you believe it right away. You don't do the due diligence to really research it. Next thing you know, you're in a trap, in a corner. Your integrity's on the line, your name's on the line, and what are you going to do? And you can't just back out right away, because then, you know, you're going to burn a bridge. This guy's going to hate you. It's a really bad situation. So that card, I did my due diligence. I checked him out, researched him, found out he's legit. I gave him a call and said, hey, you know, what do you think if I come up there? So we did a test shoot, and the test shoot landed the cover of Muscle and Fitness. If you believe in what you're doing and what your work is backloaded with is passion and love, I think it's gonna go a lot further than glory or fame or just, you know, popularity. I think those fuels burn out in that fire. But you know, at the end of the day, it's like you just gotta show up. If you show up, you at least put yourself in a position to get an opportunity. You know, if you sit at home, you know, no one's gonna come knocking on the door.
Let me ask you this, man, and you tell me what you think, or anyone here, competitors. So let's say you're all dialed in, you trained really hard, and you're really cut up, right? And you go to a shoot, and you know the world's gonna see this cover, right? And the photographer says, hey, man, we want you to go soft, don't flex. So they want to take a picture and show the world that's not your best in your mind. Are you cool with that?
or are you all ego? Saying, yeah, it's gotta be like this, it's gotta be like this. Because if you wanna be successful, you gotta be marketable. You have to have crossover. You gotta be adjust up and down 5-6 pounds. It can't all be about how cut you are, because, you know, the population at large is trying to buy this for inspiration and motivation. If you're really dialed in, the majority of the public's like, oh, he got some help with that, you know? It's like, hey, I respect the work ethic, but I don't want to go that route. You know, it's what they're thinking, maybe. You get a person in there that's kind of somewhat in shape, whatever else, the majority of people look and go, man, you know what? I respect that guy, the hard work, the right diet. It's achievable, you know? So it motivates them. Otherwise, if it's too cut up, maybe it's unattainable, and it's kind of deters their motivation. So, you know, there's a lot that goes into fitness modeling that's outside the box of the physique. It's the motivation and the mentality around the gym, because we're trying to build a lifestyle. We're not trying to build, hey, you're gonna be in shape 3 times a year and that's it. No, we're trying to build that, hey, being in shape is better, it's healthier. It's not all about the vanity, but also about, you know, the longevity, right?
I think most people think the gym is all about putting on size and everything else and building this external body. Mm-hmm. And as you know, especially in the wartime environment, in the military, the mind's your strongest weapon. I mean, how many days have you gone through hell and the body just doesn't work anymore? What keeps you going is a mindset.
Right.
You know, that's always the limiting factor. So you build that in the gym, you know, mm-hmm. and you build this way of life.
Fitness is my lifestyle. Sure, and I love every aspect of it. And so I just chase my dreams.
That's a big thing with fitness models and this career. What is your goal? What gets you up in the morning to go that distance? It can't be about the vanity of the mirror. It's got to be something deeper than that. But also, there's a whole nother army of lost souls in the civilian sector that really think this gym is this hard work and sacrifice. They don't understand the return of investment you get.